Hello and welcome to our tutorial. So I was going to try and show you something that's kind of finished. So it's not going to play back terribly smoothly, but you'll get the idea. So this is just an example of what we're trying to achieve. So it's so like a muzzle flash. We have a extra illumination on the face and the body, and a shadow, some smoke, and the actual flash itself. So what we're going to do is file new and start from scratch. So I'm going to start with my video, so it's going to drag and drop it in, throw it up here and hit fit. Now what we're interested in is the point at which we pull the trigger, so around about frame 116 or 17. So I'm going to start this project at frame 100, and then I'm going to end it at frame 150. And then the bit that we're interested in is sort of in between, so those 50 frames, which is basically 2 seconds. Okay, so that's what we're going to be working with. So we're going to take that and we're going to go add tool, 3D, image plane 3D. So I'm going to add this piece of video onto a plane so that we can have kind of a virtual camera and have that animated as well. So that's our first sort of attribute, our first asset. So I'm going to go Control C, Control V. So I'm adding another plane and another one. I don't need all these merges, but I do need one to kind of join them all together. And then the other assets that we're going to use are a very simple image here, and it's a, kind of like a flare, a lens flare, and then a small piece of video, which is kind of like a puff of smoke. So I'm going to link these, the outputs of each of these, into the image planes. Now we'll take our merge, put it in over here, and the three of them are basically sitting on top of each other here. So let's sort that out. So let's take this image plane here and drag it forward a little bit so it's got the smoke on it, and then we'll take the flare and move that out in front again. We'll zoom out a bit, and then we can see that our three images are kind of sitting there, one in front of the other. So let's get rid of the black area around these. So we're going to start with the flare, and we're going to right click. I'm going to add a matte and a luminance key. And luminance, you can see there, the dark area is going away, is a key that will remove either brightness or darkness. In this instance, we want to remove darkness. So we haven't tweaked with any of the settings. We've just kind of used their generic settings. I'm going to right click now, and I'm also going to add a 3D camera. Add that into my mix here. And I'm going to take the camera and pull it backwards to that there. And then I'm going to drop my merge here, right click, and go right click on the little widget where it says perspective, and select the camera. So this is what the camera sees. So we'll zoom out a little bit, and we can kind of zoom in and zoom out. Excuse me. Now it's important to place the camera in early, because when we start rotating and moving these, the lens flare and the smoke, it's important that we know what perspective we will need to make them look kind of realistic. Okay, so let's go to where all the action's going to happen. So it's around this frame here, about frame 180. So what we want to do is we want this flare here to only begin at frame 118. So let's do that, 118. And let's do the same with the smoke. Okay, so when we go to frame 117, they shouldn't be there. So they both start at frame 118. Excellent. So now let's take the flare and the image plane that it's on, and try and position it. So we'll go to the transform tab here in the inspector, and we will rotate on Y, and then we'll try and position this about there. Okay, so that's a nice big muzzle flare. And what we'll do is on frame 119, we'll leave it, so 118, that's fine. I'm going to go to material here and look at its opacity. And I'm going to start animating there. So I'm going to right click on its opacity and hit animate. And then I'm going to move about, you know, say to frame 122, so that's 4 frames later. And I'm going to reduce its opacity entirely. So it's basically dimming from the moment it's in. So on the first frame, actually maybe we'll leave it for 2 frames at full brightness before we let it dim. Okay, so that's in its opacity. We also want it to kind of get a little bit bigger, so the flash to sort of get larger, so that's fine there on frame 118. So if we go to these settings, let's right click on scale and hit animate. That's adding in a keyframe. Go to frame 119, make it a little bit bigger. Now when we make it bigger, it's sort of engulfing the gun there, so we're also going to animate its position. So let's move backwards and reposition this a little bit. Right there. So now let's move it forward fractionally. Then again, we'll go to frame 122 and we'll make it a little bit bigger. And if we skip back, we'll probably need to move it forward just fractionally. Okay. Now, let's position our smoke. So let's go up to frame 118, so you can see it's in the wrong position. So before we do anything else, it's going to go save as. We'll call it muzzle flash, and we'll hit save and save over what we had, just in case we get a crash. So let's reposition this plane into what should be the correct position. And again, it's a little bit large for its starting frame, so I'm going to make it smaller. And reposition it so it's just coming out in front of the gun, and we might rotate it fractionally on Y. There we go. Now as we do that, it kind of makes sort of a ring where the gun once was, and it doesn't scale at the same sort of scale as the muzzle flare, but that's fine. Okay, so I'm quite happy with that. We can work on making it maybe change its opacity, or maybe scale up a little bit, but I'm actually, you know, I think it looks alright. Okay, so we've got our basic sort of setup complete, and now what we want to look at is how do we get sort of global illumination or environmental illumination in here. And there's a few different ways to do it, but the easiest way to do it is to just use a couple of masks. So I'm going to take our these two here, so our video and our image plate here. And then you do Control-C, Control-V. And just move the new ones up here. Do that again, Control-V. So we've got two more. With the top one to start with. So I'm going to take this piece of video and drag it in here, and what I'm interested in is just making a very kind of simple mask around the face area. So I'm just going to draw a mask roughly around here. Okay, so that's my mask, and I'll just try and place it roughly around the face. Now, feather the mask a bit. So over here it says soft edge, so we'll just soften it a little bit. Now, what we want to do with this mask is we want to, first of all, add it in to our merge, so it's in here, and we want to add in, I want things to get a bit brighter, and also maybe slightly orange, because the muzzle flash has sort of a slightly yellow or orange kind of tint to it. So I'm going to add in a color correction node in here. And I need to get the mask here, so I'm going to right click on the output and drop it over into effects mask, so it knows to, you know, work on this. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to change, I'm going to just hit lift just a fraction. Oh, and I'm actually, I'm still looking at the original video, I'm not looking at the corrected one. And actually before I do that, I'm just going to hit this dot here to reset it. What I actually want to do is look at this in the right position. So our mask is not animated. So when we go to frame 118, our mask is not set correctly. This is our mask here. So what we want to do is make sure that this mask, so I'm just going to move it down fractionally here, so it's over the face. Okay. So it's in the right position for frame 118. So now, so what we're going to do now is we're going to go to the image plane and its material, and we are going to right click and animate its opacity. Frame 117, we're going to make it disappear. And on frame 118, it's back to 1, and by frame 122 we want it to disappear again. Okay, and that should make sense to you. So that's sort of, it's following the same kind of pattern as the it's the muzzle flare. So let's go up here and we'll go color correction, and on frame 118, let's throw this up here and see what we can see. So what we want to do on frame 118 is we want to lift that facial area just a tiny bit and maybe make it go towards yellow, just a fraction. So what we should get now is it's normal, and then there's sort of a subtle blast of light that accompanies the muzzle flare. Now we can make it more pronounced if we want, or more subtle. So we could probably make the mask a bit tighter, make it a bit more accurate. So I'm going to do that again. So I'm just going to take this here, and the next one I'm going to do is going to be for this body area. So again, I'm going to take my video and drop it in. Then I take a mask and very roughly draw around the body area. Let's see if we can. So we've got a frame 118, because that's the one that's the where it's going to start. So let's take that area there, maybe drop it just, you know, to maybe on the arm. So we want something quite similar, so we're going to drop in a color correction node. So under color, we'll go color correction. We'll take the output of this and bring it across and go into effects mask, and we'll take this and drop it into our merge. Okay, do that again. And we want to take the image plane, go to its material, and on frame 117, we want to set its opacity to be 0, and then animate it, set on frame 118. It is completely visible, and then by frame 122, it is invisible again. Okay, so let's try on the merge. Go to frame, say 118. Go to the color correction node that's in the correct chain. And then let's see if we can use this lift tool again to bring it up. Now, that's very crude because we didn't want, with our mask, we didn't use the soft edge tool. So we want to sort of soften the edge. Okay. Not too much, or we won't see anything at all. Right there. Go back to our color correction tool, and now let's just okay. So that's not too bad. And then the last thing we want to do is we want to take this here. So I'm gonna take that. Actually, let's just go with the piece of video. So we'll go to Control C, Control V. Oh, Cinema. Alright, so this last one here is going to be slightly different. So we'll add this into the mix. But this one is going to be for. So I'm going to take the mask and delete it. I'll take this and bring it up here. So this one's going to be quite different. So this one's going to be. To kind of draw a shadow, so we can see where the shadow is already, but we want to basically take a decent sort of wide area and some of this isn't actually visible in the scene, but that's alright. Take this area, and we're going to do kind of the opposite with this. We're going to make it darker. So I'll take the output of that, I'll drop it in here as an effects mask. And we're going to remember to soften the edges. And then we are going to zoom out, drop our merge in here. Go back to our color corrector here. We're on frame 118. So we're going to take the opposite sort of approach to this because we've duplicated it, so we need to reset it. And we also need to reset this here. So so what we want to do is make it darker. And the because we've duplicated it, the opacity setting should already be on. So it gets darker and then fades. Okay, so that's going to save this here. So file, save. So we could do lots more. But as you can see here from our node setup, there's a good few nodes in this. It's not the simplest construction in the world. If we wanted to output this now, so I'm not going to kind of cover that here, we have done that before. But if we wanted to output, what we would do is very simply we would go to Add Tool 3D and we'd go to Render 3D. So we'd have to render the output of the merge here. So we take our red output and bring that into the renderer. And then we would need a saver. So IO saver. We'll call it dale.avi, that's fine. Yeah, we can save over that one. I'll put that in there. And then we could hit the render button, hit start render, and it would render out our effect. A few things we'd need to do before that. We need to have a look at all the settings and quality and resolution and all those things that we're not going to ponder too much now. But that's how we would finish up. So what we'll do is we'll just try and play it through from start to finish, even if it doesn't play through in full frames, just to get an idea of our effect. And we'll probably just add one last thing into our effect. And that last thing is we're just going to add a tiny bit of camera shake just after the gun has been fired. So frame, say 119. So I'm going to take our camera, which is this guy here, and again we're going to go into its controls, and we're going to just keyframe everything. So its rotation and its position. So all six of these. There's a quicker way to do that, but we'll worry about it for now. So on frame 121, what we're going to do is we're going to move the camera down, but rotate it on the x-axis so that it's sort of trying to look back up. So let's move it. So it feels like the camera's had a kick down. We'll give it a second or two to sort of, or a couple of frames to recover. And normally with a camera shake, sort of it's if your camera, your hand moves down, it's going to move back up again. So we're going to move the camera up and then rotate again on X to try and. So we'll settle the play, and we may have to kind of tweak that. What we probably need is it's just too quick, that camera, that tilt. So we will remove the keyframe on 27. So I'm going to go remove key, and I'm going to bring this out a little bit, and then on this one. Fix it. Now we'll have to play that back carefully and make sure we haven't done that there, so we haven't gone over. Yeah, so we're still. So if we render this, we'll actually get black at the top of the frame, so we need to just be careful that we don't get a really good camera shake where we're not actually seeing everything in the composition. Okay, and then we need to fix that one there. Okay. So let's play that and see what we get. So you can see what we're trying to get. So the camera kind of tilts up as if the camera operator is sort of kind of taken aback, or there's a bit of movement on the camera anyway. Again, it's sort of to emphasize the motion of the gun and the motion of the action. And then what we do is we render it out, and then we'd add a nice sound effect in Resolve. Or whatever editing package you want to use. Okay, so I'm going to stop that and save our project. And I will bring this project in, and you can share it with Eve. And we can, if you're interested in this technique for your film that you'll be making with us this year, then you can obviously look back over this and use these techniques. So that's enough for now.